week because you're not to game prep yet, and it's kind of like getting a little stale. So how do you keep up beat this week?
You don't want things to get repetitive, so I mean, you got to come out with the right mindset each and every day. We're coming out here trying to work hard and, you know, set a different goal for each day, you know, just try to improve.
And what's kind of the rest of the schedule like? I know there's no availability tomorrow or Wednesday, and y'all are getting ready to start classes. What does y'all's Tuesday through Thursday look like?
You know, business as usual, meetings, going over, filming stuff, practice, you know, et cetera. Just getting ready, trying to prepare ourselves for NC State.
Corey, how much do y'all need a couple of easy days physically? Because, you know, they're hard to come by once the season starts.
Well, my mindset's set on, you know, no days off. But, I mean, of course, I mean, there's got to be some relaxation sometimes at some point, you know, in order to be fully rested and prepared for a game. But, I mean, I feel like we'll be all right, though. We got to straighten our schedule.
Do you feel like when y'all kind of back it down physically for a couple of days that when you come back and, you know, you start focusing for NC State, it'll feel – you'll feel better from that? You'll feel better from that taking a couple of easy physical days? I know you'll do film and all that other stuff.
Yeah, most definitely. We'll feel better about it. We'll come back. We'll be refreshed and ready to roll, you know, ready for another week of work.
So do y'all know anything about them yet?
We've been watching a little film. I mean, we're just trying to prepare ourselves the best way possible.
What are your early impressions? Without getting too specific, is there anything that's really jumped out at you?
Definitely. I mean, they're talented. They're talented offensively, from what I can see. And we'll have to prepare ourselves, you know, in order to be ready. But definitely a team to respect.
Corey, the depth chart's supposed to come out later this week. Do you expect to be in that too deep?
Never know. You know, I'm just playing my position, you know, doing my best job out there, trying to impress the coaches.
What do you think you've gotten better at as fall camp has progressed?
Pass rush, specifically. I mean, I still got to work on things, like keeping my pads low and stuff like that. But that'll come with due time. I'll keep working.
Well, regardless of what that 2-deep looks like, y'all do so many things on defense with sub-packages and other things. Do you feel like even guys who aren't in that 2-deep feel like they're still going to have a chance because y'all do so many different things?
Definitely. I mean, we'll rotate. You know, we'll rotate guys. We'll keep guys fresh. So, I mean, everybody's going to have an opportunity as long as they work hard.
Does this defense feel pretty good? I know y'all have had some problems against the run sometimes in camp, but overall, where do you feel like the defense is?
I feel like we're making, you know, huge strides. We're improving. There's still a long way to go, but, of course, that's for any team getting ready to play their first game. But I feel like we'll be ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Corey, just curious about the fact that just kind of where you guys at now. I mean, have you gotten to the point where you're not putting new stuff in and you're going back and polishing up, finding what you guys do best, or is it still, you know, do you still learn new stuff today?
Oh, yeah. We still learn new stuff today. Coach Sy, he's always going to put something new in. Like I said, he's the type of, he's going to look at the film, and if he see any kind of disadvantage or a chance to get ahead, you know, he's going to put something different in.
And just, I mean, watching some of the things you guys do in the nickel in particular, I mean, it looks like there's a lot of, you know, flexibility, yeah, moving around upside. Is that mostly, you know, to get guys like, you know, maybe an end like you inside and, you know, take advantage of pass rushing?
To be honest with you, man, it's that nickel's designed to free a lot of people up. More than likely, we're going to have at least one guy that's coming off scot-free. So that nickel package, it's a good package. Coach Sy did a great job with that. And we all know that we got to do our job in order to free that one person up, whether it's me or safety coming down or whatever. So, you know, he's done a pretty good job with that nickel package. We love him.
Appreciate it. Marlon, just want to talk about Coach Sinceri a little bit. When you kind of think of him, you know, it may not be just one word, but what was the first phrase that comes to mind when you think about his coaching style?
Relentless.
Relentless.
Yeah,
can you talk
relentless.
About that a little bit?
He's a high motor guy. There ain't been a day that I've come in here and his motor haven't been high. So he's the type of guy, he's always thinking about how to get ahead and how we're going to get after the quarterback or how we're going to stop plays on this certain down or whatever. But he's a very intense guy. And when you come around him, it's time to cut out all the plan and it's time to focus in and get locked in on what we got to do that day.
And how do you think that you personally respond to that kind of coaching style? You know, he is a little brash, you know, kind of gets out there, gets in you a little bit. How do you think you respond personally and then the defense as a whole?
Oh, I love it. I think we feel the same way. To have a guy around that that's been there, done that, he's accomplished the things that we're trying to accomplish here. So when a guy like that speaks, it's time to shut up and listen. So we love it. Knowing that when you come in, you got to be on top of your game. That's a great feeling, you know. So we enjoy Coach Sal a whole lot, and I'm pretty sure the whole defense feel the same way.
You kind of scared of him a little bit sometimes.
He got a certain style. I think that's that Italian in him. He's pretty good. I think a couple questions went around. We think that guy's in the mafia somewhere, but he's a pretty intense guy. We love it though.
And you think he's got the tools to, you know, that Tennessee has to be a pedigree of great defenses in the past. You think he's got that pedigree from him to lead you guys back to being one of the best defenses?
Oh, yeah. We 100% we believe in Coach Sal, and we know what he's teaching us. It's the right thing to get us where we used to be at, and And I think that's the ultimate goal for all the guys that came here, to put Tennessee back where it used to be at. So we think he's the great guy to do it because he's been there and done that. And his philosophy is just get after it, man, relentless. So, you know, he's the guy for the job.
Thanks. How much do y'all need these next couple of easier days physically? Classic and ready to start, y'all been getting after pretty hard in camp. I know you're going to do meetings and other things, but just to not mash each other for a couple of days.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a good feeling, man. We've been beating up on each other all camp. And like I said, it's a mentality, man. It's a mentality for the coaches. So it's been a pretty tough camp, but I think it's going to help us out in the long run. You know what I mean?
When y'all look at what the I think the 2D professional one comes out.